What'd the man say?
Oh, a pretty thing.
Ooh. Hey, hey. Well, come on, what'd the man say?
Well, the man said, Bob, my boy, on account of the fact that you brought Captain Anders and Lieutenant Janoshek back home alive, accept this little trinket with the thanks of a grateful republic.
Oh, go.
Sure, sure. And then he said, Bob, he always calls me Bob. Bob, my boy, if there's ever anything I could do for you, just let me know. Isn't that wonderful?
Huh? What did you say?
Well, I said to the general, Hank, I always call him Hank. Hank, there's just one thing I'd appreciate very much, a leave to spend with those two broken down pilots.
Well, you see, we're kind of used to your ugly face.
Hey, 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 wait a minute. You guys aren't walking out on me, are you?
Well, you see, Handsome and I really didn't get what you call a leave.
Yeah, it's only 10 days and...
Just one of those things, detached service. 10 days flying around the country, plugging war bonds. Well, heroes and that sort of thing.
You wouldn't like it, Bob.
They're not sending me along, huh?
Well, they thought perhaps...
Yeah, I know what they thought. Well, they're not grounding me until they have to. When do you start?
Report tomorrow morning.
Good. See you at the airport. You see, sir, we've been together ever since I left the Eagle Squadron, through everything.
I know, Major.
Yes, sir. And we'd like to stay together a little longer, at least as long as we can.
I'm afraid, under the circumstances, Major...
Sir, I've just received the Distinguished Service Cross. It doesn't really matter right now whether I really deserve it or not. I've got it, and I'm reminding you that I've got it. It ought to mean more than just a pretty ribbon.
Yes, Major, it does mean more than just a pretty ribbon.
Sir, Major Collins respectfully requests that Colonel Armstrong approve an application for detached service with the United States Treasury Department, War Bond Division, effective tomorrow morning, sir.
Put me in rather different position, Major. Although I see no reason why you really want to go.
I've forgotten, sir, who first said, eat, drink, and be merry, but, he certainly spoke my language.
You remember all he said, Major?
Yes, sir.
And?
Does it matter, sir?
I'm always stretching regulations for you. First, I let you keep your flying pay. Now, request granted. Best luck to you, Major.
Thank you, sir.
Hold it, please, gentlemen. Thank you very much.
How many notches on your propellers, boys?
Where were you wounded?
Yeah, when did you fight your last battle?
Out of the field when a bunch of Messerschmitts swooped down upon you.
Yeah, well, just about like this.
Major Collins, how many German planes have you shot down?
644.
Oh. Oh, no. Oh, that is it.
Is that too many? Well, we'll split the difference. 322.
Yeah, the rest of them got away.
Out of the field to be a war hero.
It doesn't.
What do you think of when you fly into battle?
Well, personally, I think of a girl.
Which one?
That's what I think about. I try to decide which one.
How many cities will you cover on this tour?
Oh, we don't know, really. Ask Hotchkins.
How many bombs do you propose to sell?
Ask Hotchkins.
What do you think of the home front?
Ask Hotchkins.
Where is Mr. Hotchkins?
That's what we'd like to know.
Well, who is he?
Our chaperone.
They're kind of a wet nurse.
From the Treasury Department.
Never heard of him.
Well, that's what they told us. Ivy Hotchkins. I don't know. And I wonder where he is. Yeah, I better have a look, huh? Yeah. Stay here.
Oh, Lieutenant, how long have you been in the service?
Major Collins.
Yeah?
Could I have your autograph, please?
Mine? Sure. There you are.
Thank you, Major.
You're welcome.
Major Collins?
Yes?
I'm terribly sorry. I'm from the United States Treasury.
Oh, you are? Well, how do you do?
How do you do?
Yes, I'm from the United States Army Air Forces. And in the Army, we're never sorry. We're on time or else. Now, would you go back to Mr. Ivy Hotchkiss and tell him that for me? And, oh, yes, you may also tell him...
I am Ivy Hotchkiss.
Well, that's... You're who?
Ivy Hotchkiss, Ivy White, Ivy.
You mean that, that you're taking us on this tour?
I am.
Well, what the...
My boss was supposed to go with you, but he had an automobile accident on his way to the airport. I had to rush you as fast as I could. There was nobody else to send.
Oh. Well, yes, but a girl. My orders don't say anything about an Ivy White. It just says I period B period Hotchkiss.
Mine, too. I guess somebody's made a mistake.
Yes. What seems to be the matter with the Treasury Department?
The Treasury Department has no time for sex discrimination.
Well, that's fine. So you're,
You're going to take charge of us, huh?
That's what I'm here for.
Uh-huh. Well, supposing you start by finding me a briefing room.
I don't quite understand.
A briefing room. You know, it's where we go just before we take off on a mission. Very private, very confidential. I need a place like that to say goodbye to my, my sister.
Yes, Major. I'll take care of it.
Thank you.
What do you think of the English fighting men, Captain?
This England never did nor ever shall lie at the proud foot of a conqueror. Come the three corners of the world in arms, and we shall shock them.
Yeah.
Huh?
That's Shakespeare. In fact, to King John.
That's right. You were a teacher, weren't you, Captain?
Pinkerton College, Nebraska.
Yeah, 33 pupils, including a janitor's niece.
Two nieces.
They will have the little joke, you know.
Well, I suppose that's about it.
Glad to have met you, gentlemen.
Well, have a good day.
Thank you.
Goodbye, Major.
Hey, did you find that Hotchkiss guy?
Yeah, I found him.
What's he like?
Oh, fine. A bit old for his age. Delicate, you know. We'll have to go easy on him.
Oh, 4F, huh?
Yeah, no, not exactly. Just not the combat type. Definitely not. Come on, let's get this stuff on the ship.
Will this room suit your requirements, Miss Hotchkiss?
Yes, I think so. All they want is privacy and say goodbye to their families.
Oh, of course. Are you really in charge of this whole tour?
Yes.
Well, if you don't mind my saying so, I think you're going to have your hands full.
Why?
Well, those three charges of yours have every appearance of being, wolves.
Wolves?
Wolves.
But I don't happen to be Little Red Riding Hood.
Oh?
Major Collins.
Oh, Miss Hotchkiss, we've been waiting for you. This is Shakespeare and this is Handsome. Fellas, this is Hodger from the Treasury.
Who?
The what? Mr. Hotchkiss.
But that's a dame.
Shh. A lady.
Oh.
I've arranged the briefing room, Major, right over there. First door past the hangar.
Oh, excuse me, gentlemen, but my story is incomplete. I have some more questions.
I presume you take care of our press conferences, Miss Hotchkiss?
That's one of my duties, Major.
Good. Take care of this one. We'll have to be going. Miss Hotchkiss here will answer all your questions correctly. I'm sorry, but you know the government. Hush, hush.
Tell her how to come out of a tailspin in an air pocket at normal room temperature.
And what to do when your gear ship sticks in second at 20,000 feet.
Oh, but my story.
Oh, I'm sure if you're very, very nice to her, she'll tell you what's to be done with the post-war world.
Honest.
Well, goodbye, beautiful.
Are you going to miss me?
Sure, you bet.
But you've only known me a couple of days.
Oh, it's a lifetime, Wilma.
Gertrude.
Or a lifetime, Gertrude.
Mind if I watch? Is that a secret weapon you're trying out?
Oh, no secret at all. Everybody knows about it.
The plane is ready to leave.
Oh, is it now? Well, I'm not. I forgot something. Something for you to remember me by.
What is it?
Well, it's called a pour le mérite for valor.
Oh, you darling. I didn't know you cared so much. Does she have to watch?
Excuse me.
I have a ribbon for you, sweetie.
Gee, but I don't deserve it.
Oh, yes, you do.
But you want it in Normandy.
And you want it in Washington.
You remind me of Boston.
But I've never been to Boston.
Me either. Oh!
Now come along, gentlemen. All good things must come to an end.
All right, break it up, gang. Say goodbye to Handsome, girls. Goodbye again, girls. Up the ward.
Don't anyone tell you we don't make sacrifices for our country.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Are we going to have a kissing scene everywhere we go?
Well, we certainly hope so.
I certainly hope so.
Well, ladies and children first.
Then what are you waiting for?
Oh, pretty charm, Roger.
Come on, hoist her in, boys. Oh, get here.
Hey, Bob, give me another one of them pour le mérite. I planted mine.
Yes, sir. Here you are. 2 cents piece does the work of a dinner, theater, or champagne.
Or a box of candy, maybe.
Have one?
What are they?
Pour le mérite. It's a kind of a decoration.
What kind of a decoration?
Oh, this little thing we picked up on the other side of the water.
What'd you do to get them?
Well, we don't get them, we give them.
Where did you get them?
Bought them in a shop, shilling a dozen.
But what are they for?
Well, you might say they're for valor in the face of the opposite sex. We give them to all the pretty girls we meet. Have one.
I don't think I'd like any, thank you.
No, of course you wouldn't.
Well, of course she would.
Oh, gosh, Hotch, don't take us too seriously. We're just not used to all this, you know. Reporters, interviewers, making speeches and all that. We'll improve. Honest, we will. Are we friends?
Friends.
Friends. Me too.
I know you didn't expect to have a woman along on this trip. Suppose you just forget I'm here and be yourselves. I don't want to cramp your style.
Oh, well, I'll do that the deal.
Say, Hotchie, you don't look very comfortable there. Let me help you.
No,
you
want me here.
Put your feet up on the
table. Now, wait a minute. Not too much good manners.
Not too much good manners, handsome.
Oh.
Say, Hotchie, take off your hat, will you? Well, hubba, hubba, hubba.
Well.
Say, that's not bad, you know. Not bad at all.
Hollister, have you here in Boston?
Thank you.
Hollister, please.
Thank you.
Now, if you'll just come along with me.
Mr. Chairman.
Yes?
We have hotel reservations.
No. Have the luggage sent to the hotel. But we're going straight to my house for dinner. Dinner's waiting for us. Just a small dinner.
Oh, that's nice.
Yes, about 30 people.
30?
Here. Then after dinner, we're going to the big bond rally at the stadium. There'll be thousands there to hear you make a speech, Major Collins.
That's what I always want to hear, him making a speech.
Would you take care of the luggage, Miss...
Hotchkiss.
Miss Hotchkiss.
I'll be glad to. I'm here to help in any way I can.
Oh, Hotch is a big help.
Is there anything I can do to help you, Major Collins?
No, I think nothing.
Oh, yes, there is. Go ahead, fella.
Come here.
Akron, Atlantic City, Baltimore, Birmingham, here it is, Boston. Call that number right there and tell him I'll be over later.
Wait a minute. Peggy Levere, Club 400. Alice Johnson, Congress 4471. Maisie. And why the question mark, may I ask?
Question mark? Oh, I don't know her last name. Never mind, Maisie. Just call Peggy Levere at the Club 400. Understand?
Understand perfectly, Major Collins.
Yeah.
Come along, Major.
See you later, Hotcha.
Yeah, see you later, Hotcha.
Red cap. This luggage, please.
Understand, when I say, here come the three musketeers of the skies, these doors will open. Oh, come in, Miss Hotchkiss.
Oh, hiya, Hotcha. Come on in.
Hiya, Hotcha.
Hi.
Have a drink.
No, thank you.
You didn't lose it, did you?
Lose what?
the book, the valuable book.
Oh. Here are your vital statistics, Major Collins. The lady is expecting you.
Thank you.
After the bond rally.
Oh, naturally.
The guests are waiting. I think I'd better go in first and make the announcement. Now remember, Maestro, when I say, here come the three musketeers of the sky, you start the air corps song. You enter on the same beat.
Oh, yes, sir.
Certainly.
Is it really necessary to leave them here alone?
Oh, now, Miss Hotchkiss, we must do everything properly, you know.
Oh, we mustn't disappoint the guests.
We've got to be gentlemen.
Come along, Miss Hotchkiss. I give you my arm.
Take it, Miss Hotchkiss.
Come along, Miss Hotchkiss. Oh, good evening, everybody. No, don't get up. The guests aren't ready yet. Hello, Miss Perkins. Now, don't forget, Maestro. Remember your instructions. You sit here, Miss Hotchkiss. Ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. ladies and gentlemen, speech making is the curse of our century. Too many people speak too much, take too long, and say too little. Nowadays, words are supposed to do anything except to have any kind of sense. Words spoken today have no meaning tomorrow, sometimes not even today. Therefore, I shall not burden you with a long speech. It would be futile to attempt to do justice to their achievements through mere oratory. And to make a long story short, liberty, equality, fraternity and democracy. And now, here come the three musketeers of the skies. Here come the three musketeers of the skies. Here come the three musketeers of the skies. What?
Will you take me to the Club 400?
What's that?
You want the boys at your big bond rally, don't you?
Oh, yes, of course. We've got to have them.
Well, come on. This is the place, all right. Did you have a hat, sir?
Yes, but I haven't got it with me.
And where did you get that, may I ask?
Oh, this is called Pour le Mérite. It's given for valor beyond the line of duty.
This is the place, all right. Come on.
Nice gardenia for the lady.
Oh, no time for flowers. Look, she's got one, too.
Come on.
Table for two, madame.
You see, he doesn't wear any ribbons.
No, I never did.
Where do you keep those 20 beautiful girls?
Yes, where do you keep those beautiful girls?
The floor show doesn't start for the next 20 minutes.
Where do you keep them now?
Straight ahead. The lady, not you.
Not me.
Would you really like to go in there?
Yeah.
So would I.
Come, come. Sit thee down upon this flowery bed, while I thy amiable cheeks do coy, and stick musk roses in thy sleek smooth head, and kiss thy fair large ears, my gentle joy.
Well kissed, an excellent courtesy.
I hope I'm not intruding. What do you mean by walking out on me?
Oh, walking
out? Now, you come along with me right now.
You better come along with her.
Oh, gee, Mrs. Collins, I didn't know he was married.
Please, Mrs. Collins, it's all my fault. I merely invited Bob out to have a drink with me because, well, I was lonesome, and we encountered these ladies.
I'm awfully sorry, Mother. Oh, really, I am.
Are the children waiting up for me?
Yeah, the kids waiting up for me.
All right, say goodnight to your little girlfriends. Come on, we've got one.
All right, yes, Mother. Good night, little girlfriends.
Night, little girl. Don't
forget. Okay. Mother.
Bye.
Good night's work.
Now to get the rest of the night off, teacher?
Guess you've earned it.
Peggy, Elise, Maisie.
Maisie, I can't... What about you two? Are you coming back to the hotel?
Well, I kind of like to take a look at the city.
Great city, Boston, full of historical landmarks.
Right ahead, I'm going to bed.
Roger.
Who?
Roger.
Roger what?
Bacon, Williams, Hornsby, take your choice.
Are you talking about?
Oh, I don't pay any attention to those guys, Hotcher. Roger's just airplane talk. It means okay, sure. Everything's under control.
Thank you, handsome.
Corrine Kranz.
3 stars.
Well, have a good time.
Oh, we will. Just a moment. This is for you.
Why?
So you won't be lonesome.
Thank you. Our plane leaves tomorrow morning at 7 o'clock.
Hmm?
Go ahead and look at your historical landmark.
Well, we have them all noted down in here.
I'll have a briefing room ready.
Fine, we'll probably need it.
Well, good night.
Good night.
Yes? No? Yes? Goodbye. Do you have a reservation?
I believe the Treasury Department took care of it.
Fine. Hotchkiss, is that right?
Roger.
Did you say Rogers?
No, Hotchkiss.
Well, that's funny. I was sure you said Rogers.
What I said was Roger.
Oh? Oh. Oh. Yes, 233. Boy. Boy, take the lady to 233.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Come.
You'll be comfortable here.
Thank you. Will you leave that bag at the desk for Major Collins? They put it in the wrong room.
Yes, ma'am. Anything else?
No, thank you. Oh. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good night.
Good night.
Lovely town, Boston. Grand.
Delightful, delightful.
We have to get up in a few hours.
Yeah.
Oh. Oh. Little Hodger had the right idea. She went to bed.
Mrs. Bob Collins.
Very funny fellow.
So you know Hodger isn't a bad kid, is she?
Yes, you'll do.
You got a neat pair of gams, too. Oh, boy.
Look, as far as you're concerned, she's still Mr. Hotchkiss. Mr. Hotchkiss.
Mr. Hotchkiss, old boy.
Did you have a reservation?
Oh, yes, Major Collins. There you are. This is yours, isn't it, Major?
Roger.
I beg your pardon?
Yeah, it's mine.
I'll have the bellboy for you in just a minute.
Oh, no, never mind. Boogie.
You are obliging.
I think I'm in a bunk with you, Bob. Handsome snore.
Oh, I do not.
Shh. Now, look. This is the first time I've had a room to myself since I've been with you guys. And I'm going to enjoy the solitude.
Yeah, Bob, but
them's orders, Cap Matters.
Out loud.
What are you doing here?
Who, me? Well, I was just going to bed.
Oh, you really think so, huh?
Well, that's what I had in mind. Say, incidentally, what are you doing here?
This only happens to be my room.
233?
Yes, 233.
This is a swell hotel you picked out. I like the way they arrange things, don't you?
Will you kindly get out?
Now, why should I? This is my room, too. You see, I've got the same...
Look, Lothario, I know that you're a great man with an airplane. I know that you're a hero and all that. I know that you're heaven's gift to the women of America. But it just so happens that I'm not having any. So put on your pants and get out of here.
Hey, Bob, handsome snoring is...
I beg your pardon. I didn't know you had company.
Shakespeare.
Haven't seen a thing.
You come here.
You really want me to come in here?
Yes, we... Yes, we do.
All right.
Look here, I came to my room hours ago and went to bed. I wake up and find out that this man has broken in.
Without his pants?
He must have taken them off.
Yes, I can see that.
So will you please throw him out of here?
No, wait a minute, I gotta sleep. You can't just
Look, children. Just keep calm and Papa will take care of everything.
Well, don't just stand there. Put on your pants.
Desk clerk.
This is the desk.
Could you please tell me who's registered in 233?
Let me see. We have the captain and lieutenant in 232, and Major Collins and Mr. Hotchkiss in 233.
Mr. Hotchkiss?
Yes, Mr. I.V. Hotchkiss.
Roger.
I'll have to look that up.
You look what up?
The reservation for Mr. Roger.
All right. We'll work it out.
Hey, you guys.
Oh.
Oh!
Shh!
Hey, what's going on in here?
Shh. Well, as long as Handsome's here, we might as well match for it. Odd man.
Match for what?
Oh, that phony quarter. Look, Handsome, there's been a mix-up. Mr. Hotchkiss, the rooms are all...
Well, you can bunk in with us, Bob.
Sure. You can sleep on the floor. Oh, you think so, huh? Well, Captain Anders, you leave me no alternate. I'll have to rank you out of your bed.
Lieutenant Yanoshek, I'll just have to rank you out of yours.
Hey, why don't we bring a sergeant along?
Good night.
Forgot your bag.
Well, pick it up.
night.
Good night, you idiots. That's what comes to studying historical landmarks until the early hours of the morning.
Don't mention it.
What's the matter with your shoulder?
Oh, nothing. A little stiff. Old.
Does it hurt much?
Only when I slip on my right shoulder.
What happened to it?
The hydraulic system got shot away and had to make a belly landing. Broke two ribs and one of them nicked a lung.
Is it all right now?
On the beam. Not even any scar tissue. I'm a lucky guy. Knock on wood. Hey, Hanson, put up your leg here. I'm gonna knock on wood.
Hey, what's going on here?
Just telling Ivy about my old wounds, old soldier stories.
If you want to talk about wounds, talk to me. They didn't give me that for a measly couple of busted ribs. Well, I broke more ribs than that in Madison Square Garden. All I ever got was a bum decision. I got wounds.
What happened to Bob?
Bob? I never asked him. Yeah, that's right. I never asked him about it.
Say, aren't we about doing Chicago? Say, that's where you fought Lefty McGinnis, isn't it?
Yeah.
Did you ever know Hanson was a prize fighter?
A teacher and a prize fighter. What was Bob before the war?
He was an engineer, wasn't he?
Oh, they'll need plenty of engineers after the war. He's the lucky one, isn't he?
Yeah. Yeah, I guess he is.
Yeah, I guess he is. Give me my comic book, will you?
There you are.
Thanks.
Well, buckle up your belts, children. Chicago's coming up.
That's what's wrong with airplanes.
What?
They fly too fast. When's a man going to relax?
After the bond drafting. We're due at the Victory Center at noon. So if you had any more bright ideas about escaping, not a chance.
Well, that suits me fine. Let's get the speech making over with first. Will you let go of us after that?
Certainly. You can have the afternoon off, the evening, and the night. So I hope you have plenty of numbers in Chicago.
Oh. You don't care, do you?
Why should I care?
Oh, it's a little dangerous, isn't it? Letting us loose in a big city like Chicago?
Oh, I imagine the city will survive.
I thought you were supposed to look after us.
Just what do you expect me to do?
You wouldn't know of a blonde, for example, height about 5'4", weight, 115 pounds, disposition rotten, who'd be free tonight, would you?
Well, that's the rudest way anyone's ever asked me for a date.
What do you say?
I don't have a rotten disposition.
Oh, you'll have to prove that. How about dinner in a place with a good dance band afterward?
Roger.
Hey, get him.
Get this straight. The county chairman will call for you at noon and take you to the Victory Center.
Mm-hmm.
Don't keep him waiting.
Mm-hmm.
He'll expect to find you right here.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, you're not deserting us, are you?
I have another engagement.
Yeah? Have you a date?
Oh, very.
With whom?
The hairdresser.
Oh.
I'll see you later.
That's all right. Say, that's not a bad idea. I think I could use a haircut myself. Handle this, will you?
Beauty parlor. Barber shop. Oh.
You know, she's not a bad kid. She ought to have a good time for a change.
Yeah, she's had it pretty rugged with us.
We ought to do something for her.
You know, she'd be a knockout with the right camouflage. But don't you think it sacrifices lift to maneuverability?
It's sort of easy to land and hard to take off.
Do you have something special in mind?
Oh, very special.
We'd like an evening dress for tonight.
Well, what type are you interested in?
Oh, we're not interested. A friend of ours is.
Well, what style?
Well, not much. That's what we've got to teach her.
What?
A style.
Yes, but what kind of dress do you want?
Well, sort of a solid conservative body with a forward-looking design.
Well, this is very chic.
Well, we'd like something a little chicier.
Oh, Josephine.
Say, Bob could really go for that, couldn't he?
Yeah, that'd suit him fine.
That's long-range cruising at top speed.
Say, could we have it traded and delivered for this evening?
Why, yes.
Would you please send that to Miss Ivy Hotchkiss at the Lake Plaza Hotel?
Certainly. Cash or charge?
That'll be cash. How much?
$180, including the tax.
Oh, could you enclose a card with that?
Hey, $180.
No, handsome, you're not backing out, are you?
Oh, all right.
Make that card out from an anonymous friend.
From two anonymous friends. 50-50.
Oh, now, wait.
Well, you said we'd go 50-50. You got half my dough there.
But this is supposed to be anonymous.
Well, so what? Oh. I want my half of the anonymous, too.
Hey, we better run along. He'll have a fit.
Who?
The county chairman. We're not supposed to keep him waiting. Come on.
And while I'm kissing them sentimentally, keep the liberal point of view, because I'm breaking it to them gently that my heart belongs to you. Daddy, please remember this, that tomorrow starts a life of bliss. Let me show them what they're gonna miss. Kiss the boys goodbye. Kiss the boys goodbye.
We almost missed it. You go on in 5 minutes.
Hubba, hubba, hubba.
What did you say?
Hubba, hubba.
Oh, I don't understand that language.
Well, it's universal.
Hubba, hubba, hubba.
May I have your autograph, please? Oh,
certainly.
Me too?
Thought you were wonderful. Thank you very much.
Hey, how much you pay for that?
Quarter.
Here's a buck. Is that a deal?
Sold.
May I have your autograph next, Miss Heath?
Certainly. It's a pleasure.
Come on, kid. Break it up. Out of here. Come on. Get going.
Why, Major Collins.
Well, hello.
Oh, I hoped I'd have a chance to meet you. I saw your pictures in the paper.
Well, thanks.
I who should be asking you for an autograph.
Oh, I'll trade autographs with you any day.
Hey, we had our pictures in the paper, too, me and Shakespeare.
Oh, yes. Excuse me. This is Captain...
Oh, don't tell me. Captain Anders and Lieutenant Janicek.
Hey, she knows our names.
I'm your pinup girl, am I not?
You bet. Tis but her picture I've yet beheld, and that hath dazzled my reason's light. But when I look on her perfections, there is no reason but I will be blind.
That's Shakespeare. He can do that all day.
Yeah, if you let him.
Ah, nice. Are you staying in Chicago for long?
Well, no. You see, we're just going to be here tonight. We're flying to Des Moines in the morning.
Oh, well, then you must spend the evening with me.
Huh?
Would you repeat that again, please?
I said you must spend the evening with me.
Gosh, you mean it?
Of course I mean it, and I won't take no for an answer.
Who'd ever give you no for an answer?
I can't let you be lonely, can I?
Oh, no.
It's a date.
I'll have a couple of friends of mine in to meet you, my most special friends. Not a big party, just a small, intimate affair.
How do you do?
How do you do?
You don't say.
I'm staying at the Maywood. Now, you must come early and stay late, since we have only this evening.
The Maywood. We'll be there.
Fine. Please, Major, Captain, Lieutenant, the audience is waiting.
Oh, yes.
Oh, well, then I mustn't keep
you. Well, we'll see you tonight, huh?
You won't disappoint me.
Well, we never had any complaints yet.
Well, goodbye for now.
Bye-bye. Bye.
Hubba, hubba, hubba. Please, gentlemen.
Oh, yes. Now, come on, fellas, straighten up. Fly right.
Come in. What's that?
From Colette's dress shop, madam, by special messenger.
I didn't order anything from a dress shop.
Miss Ivy Hotchkiss?
Yes.
It's for you, madam.
Thank you.
What are you doing in Chicago? I'm here on official business, too. How did you know I was here? Oh, yes, there has been a lot of publicity in the papers about the tour. Oh, now, Bill, you don't have to be jealous of the Army Air Corps. I'd really love to, Bill, but I have a date tonight. Official business. Yes, I'm awfully sorry, too. Where are you staying? Fine, I'll give you a ring later on when I come back. Of course I will. Goodbye, Darlene. Do you know if Major Collins has gone out?
I just saw the Major going into the flower shop, madam.
Thank you.
Hotchkiss?
Yes?
This telephone message was left for you at the desk.
Well, thank you.
Miss Joyce Heath live here?
Yes, madame is expecting you.
Ah, madame is expecting you. Very good. Here, boy, hold my hat.
Good evening.
Hello.
I'm so glad you could come.
Thanks.
Good evening. Hello.
Well, we just brought a few little...
For me, how sweet. Thank you very much. We're all waiting for you in here.
Thank you.
Hello there.
Well, hello.
Hello.
Major Collins, Captain Anders,
how do you
Lieutenant
do?
Janusz.
How do you do?
How do you
do?
Dear Miss Cavendish.
Nice to
know.
Oh.
And, gentlemen, Commander McCurran.
How do you do, sir?
How do you do?
And Lieutenant Commander Nelson.
How do you do, sir?
How do you do?
It's nice having you, gentlemen. Please be seated.
Thank you.
I didn't want you to be lonely in a strange town.
We're glad to do our bit for the war effort. Aren't we, darling?
We didn't realize it was going to be an amphibious operation. You sure we're not intruding now?
Of course not. The Army need never be lonely as long as little Joycey has a home front.
You boys have seen a lot of Europe, haven't you?
Europe?
Oh, yes.
Well, we...
Well, then maybe you can help us decide. George and I were just discussing where to spend our honeymoon after the war.
Oh. George and you?
Yes.
Oh, I'm George.
Oh. Hello, George. Congratulations, George.
Thank you.
Oh, I must open my lovely flowers.
Maybe you boys would like some drinks.
Certainly would.
Oh.
Yeah, we certainly would.
Can I help you with that?
Oh, thank you.
Say, how about throwing a little flag at Shakespeare and Hanson to drive him off? That'll make an even six. Hate's a little crowded, huh?
Well, I... Darling! Come in. This is Captain Taylor, my husband.
How do you do, Major?
Taylor's my real name, you know.
Oh, how interesting.
Take a chair, Major.
Yes, thank you.
Tom, this is Captain Anders and Lieutenant Janoschek.
As you were, gentlemen, as you were. Oh, I happen to have my souvenir album here. I dare say you gentlemen would enjoy seeing some pictures of our naval activities. Now, this one. This one is of the class of Annapolis, 1990.
Nothing can stop the Army Air Corps. Well, that was a quick evening, wasn't it?
Charming. You said it.
Say, I think I'll see if there's any mail. Anything for you fellas, I'll pick it up.
Look, old boy, I have to pick up something in the drugstore. See you later.
Oh, sure.
Hello. Why, hello, Bob. Why, no, I didn't think that was a date. We were just talking, weren't we?
Well, yeah, but Hodger, look, I got rid of Shakespeare and Handsome and some important people, oh, very important, just to get back here as soon as I could, see? Well, but honey, you don't know what I've been through. You don't know the half of it.
Well, wait in the lobby until I get down. Bye. Hello. Why, hello, Shakespeare.
I don't offer good quotation, and it's not Shakespeare. Better late than never. I ditched Bob and Handsome just to get here in a hurry.
Well, I'll be down in the lobby in a few minutes. See you then. Bye. Hello, Handsome. What's on your mind?
Well, I thought you might get lonesome, so I brushed off Bob and Shakespeare.
All right. I'll meet you in the lobby in a few minutes. Bye.
Thank you.
Ivy.
It's so good to see you.
It's wonderful to see you, too.
Have a large navy.
Yeah, the fleet must be in Lake Michigan. Looks like our little Ivy's lived.
Yeah, even before she met us. Shall I slug the guy?
Don't be primitive, Lieutenant.
Hey, can that be the same girl? Let's find out.
What you're up to behind my back. You come home with me at once.
Aren't you ashamed running out on your husband like this?
With a sink full of dirty dishes and all them kids crying.
Sir? Yes? Did you happen to know that she's a married woman? No, did you? This man has no conscience at all.
It won't work.
It won't? It won't work, fellas.
Bill knows better. There's a reason.
There is?
Sure.
Lieutenant Allen, this is Major Collins, Captain Anders, Lieutenant Genesee.
How you doing?
How you doing?
How are you? Well, we didn't realize we'd have the pleasure. Well, go ahead. Sit down. Yes, you sit down.
Thank you. Thanks very much.
Just what is this, Lieutenant Allen? Convoy duty?
Yes, Major. But outside the range of land-based bombers.
You making for port or just a flat top?
Oh, we've made it already. It's all set.
What?
Our future plans.
That's what it looked like to me.
Like what?
You two was having a very serious talk.
Oh, very. Getting married is a very serious subject.
Getting married?
Of course you're all invited to the wedding.
My congratulations.
Thank you.
Congratulations. Isn't this rather sudden?
Oh, no. Bill and Francis have been engaged for months.
Bill and who?
My sister Francis.
Well, where is she?
With my Uncle Jack.
Well, where's your Uncle Jack?
In California.
That's funny. I don't get that.
Huh.
Well, Bill and Francis will be married in California, and they've set the date for next week when we're due down there, so that I'll be able to attend the wedding. You're all invited, too.
Oh, you mean... Well, our sincere congratulations, all that's wonderful. Drag up
his name. Congratulations.
Certainly appreciate the invitation. We do. Well, we'll drink at your wedding.
As a matter of fact, we'll get drunk at your wedding.
Glad to have you.
Women, what a blessing.
Do you really think so, Major?
You're darn right. Ivy, you look wonderful.
Oh, thank you.
That's certainly a beautiful dress you have on.
Oh, that, it's nothing much. Just an old thing of mine. I picked it up at a bargain sale in New York.
Oh, swell.
What's the matter, Shakespeare?
Oh, nothing, nothing at all.
I told you that anonymous stuff wouldn't work.
Why, yes, handsome, it worked. That's what makes me feel so sad that I've got no idea who sent this dress to me.
Why?
If I knew who it was, I'd have something to say to him.
Well, what would you say to him?
I'd say it's the most wonderful dress I've ever seen. And they're a couple of the nicest fools I've ever met. But since I don't know them, I'm not going to say.
Hey, what's going on here anyway?
Nothing, nothing at all. Oh.
Oh, so that's why you guys were late this morning, huh? Well, nice work, boys, nice work. Now, why couldn't I think of a thing like that myself?
Well, that's the trouble with you. You have no imagination.
Now, you take the English, for instance. Hard people to do business with.
Can't understand a word they say.
Yeah. Take this Englishman and come into my office. Hoffman's too, he says. Why can't he say half like everybody else?
You think they'd learn to speak English?
I think we've got your table there.
Yes. We have... no. Well, here's to the Air Corps. Hiya, fellas. Can I buy a little drink?
Well, no, you see, we just... Rachel. Jolly good of you, old boy. Oh, yes. Hands across the sea and all that. Lieutenant Chumley, will you join us?
Waiter, see whether the folks will have.
Would you have a spot to drink, Pamela?
Pim's number 10 fruit.
Scotch and splash for me, old boy.
A gin and tonic, what?
A bottle of beer. Straight bourbon, please.
Well, I say, old chaps, this is frightfully decent of you. We're keen on America, what?
A ripping country.
Yes, well.
Nigel, you do pick up the language.
You know, I could have sworn you fellas were Americans. Your uniforms are just like ours.
Oh, that. Lend lease, old boy.
What's the ribbons?
Oh, just medals.
What'd you do to get them?
Oh, nothing. Nothing at all, really.
Oh, come now, Percy. Do tell the gentleman how you won the medal.
Yeah, spill it. Don't hold nothing out on
him. My dear Nigel, do stop talking like a gangster in the cinema.
Now tell us about the parachute, won't you?
Yes, well, actually, you see... About the what?
The parachute.
Percy, the parachute.
Oh, the parachute. I forgot all about it. Well, this is a perfectly incredible story. Of course, I shouldn't want you to think I'm leading you up the garden path. Yes, well, our chaps were winging across the channel one night with a jolly squadron when a covey of Jerry's dropped out of a cloud, right?
Righto.
Yes, and six of them, mind you, dove straight for Reg here, cannons going like mad, and in half a moment they'd shot out his engine. There was nothing for it but for Reg to how do you Americans say that? Is it strike the silk?
Hit the silk.
Oh, exactly. Thank you, old beans. Hit the silk. So Reg here hit the silk. And then the most frightful thing, as he floated past, I noticed his chute was on fire, don't you know? Very ticklish what? Well, you see, I just let old Reg have a fiver the night before he'd been on, sort of a hanky-panky with a dancer from the Hippodrome. Oh, charming girl, what? And, well, I just couldn't allow the blighter to perish before my eyes. Don't forget my scotch and spice, will you, old man?
Very good, sir.
Where was I?
You were watching the captain fall with his parachute on fire?
Oh, yes. So I dove my spit, you see, under him and came up sharply, and he lit right on the tail assembly.
Marvelous.
You bet that knocked him for a loop.
Say, you English or American?
Yes.
No. I mean, which one?
Well, you see, O'Bean, the mater is Lady Tittering on the Brink. The old man was a drummer from Chicago. So you see, I'm half and half.
Excuse me, would you care for a spot of dancing or anything?
Oh, rightfully good of you to ask.
Thank you very much for the drinks, old boy. You later. Goodbye.
What I say is the British are the finest bunch of people on earth.
Righto.
Now my pleasure to present our lovely guest star, Miss Helen Forrest.
You came to me from out of nowhere. You took my heart.
Sorry about standing you up tonight.
That's all right.
I might need that parachute after all.
Parachute? Why?
Well, you got me up in the air. I might need something to break the fall.
No, you won't. I intend to keep you up in the air.
Oh, you do, huh? Hey, you're speaking my language now. Is that a deal? Just fun up in the air?
Just that.
Just that.
Major, old boy.
Yes?
May I cut in?
Well, if you don't mind, Captain, old thing, we'll be in Des Moines tomorrow. You may take your turn then.
As you wish, sir.
Carry on.
Cheerio. Looks like the dress was a hit.
Yes. Too much so.
What do you mean?
Oh, never mind.
You don't take anything seriously, do you?
No.
Why?
Oh, too many things to take seriously.
I like people who know how to laugh.
Well, there's no trick to that. Anybody can laugh when they should. The trick is to laugh when you shouldn't.
When you shouldn't?
Mm-hmm. Come on.
Major, if you're trying to sneak out, don't go this way. There's a mob of autograph hunters outside.
Oh, thanks a minute.
Down to the end and turn you right.
Down. Thank you. Oh, hello.
Where are you going?
Well, we just...
Where are you going?
We were just,
Wait a minute. Said when we got to Des Moines, it was our turn.
Now, look, all we want is a little privacy and a chocolate soda. We'll be in Seattle tomorrow. You can have Seattle. So, see you later. Understand?
No, we don't.
The major says see you later. Got it? Well, get it.
Happened, and so did you.
It's the song Bob and I danced to in Chicago.
Oh, nice.
Wonderful dreams, da 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 da, from nowhere, made every hour sweet as a flower to me. You should go back to your nowhere, leaving me with a memory. I'll always wait for your return out of nowhere, hoping you'll bring your love to me.
You can count on it, sister.
Hi, Hutcher.
Oh, now look, I was definitely told Seattle was my turn.
Oh, now, take it easy, son. You can take your turn in San Francisco. How thoughtful.
Hey, wait.
This is mine, I take it. Why don't you have a drink, too?
Oh, I just can't win.
I'll have the same. And be sure that the glass is clean.
Well, Hotch, I didn't know you played the piano. Go ahead with the concert.
Yeah, play some more.
All right.
I beg your pardon. It's all crowded.
It certainly is. Where's Bob and Hans?
Oh, some general wanted to see them at the Presidio. They'll be along shortly.
San Francisco's a big city. Will they know where to find us?
Oh, it's certainly. It's a cinch. The nearest bar. Oh, here's the table over here. Let's grab it. What'll you have?
A little sherry, if you don't mind.
I don't mind at all, as long as I don't have to drink it. Sherry and a bourbon and soda.
Sherry, bourbon, and soda. Right.
Well, alone at last. Chicago, Des Moines, Seattle. It's certainly taking me a long time to cut in. Remind me to kiss you one of these days.
Excuse me.
Oh,
Well, Captain Anders, how are you, Captain?
Colonel, fine, sit down.
Thanks. Your shoulder giving you any trouble?
No.
Feel anything here?
Mm-mm.
Everything all right?
Good as new, Doctor. Ivy, this is Colonel Stubbs, Miss Hotchkiss.
How do you do, sir?
Pleasure. Always find Captain Anders with the best-looking girl in the place. Great ladies' man. Had to warn all the nurses when he was in the hospital.
Thank you.
Cigarette?
No, thanks.
What are you doing in San Francisco, Colonel?
Just got back from New Guinea. Had an interesting time down there. Investigating scrub typhus for the Army. Helped them with an unusual case of chronic malaria, too. A very interesting case. A general had a great big spleen and anemic as an oyster. But no fever.
Oh, thank you. Won't you have another one, Colonel?
No, thanks. One's enough for me. Here, Tom. Getting back to the general, I fixed him up as good as new.
I'll bet you did a bet.
Important man, tough case. They always send for me.
You know, the funny thing is, Pete's probably right. The best medico in the service.
Certainly. Oh, take the case of that friend of yours, the flyer. They had a lot of trouble with him until they called me in. I spotted it like that. A very interesting case. Very unusual. Tricky to diagnose.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry, Colonel.
Forget it.
Maybe I better call a waiter.
No, nothing at all. White corpuscles multiply too fast. Nothing anybody can do about it. Sulfa drugs, penicillin, all of them no good. A fine, strapping fellow. A major, and very young for a major, too. Looks as healthy as you and I. A month or two, maybe a year, any time at all over. 2 years at the outside. Good friend of yours, buddy. Say, Moffitt? Yes, that's right, say, Moffitt. Seen him lately?
Well, he died a couple weeks ago, Doctor.
That's so. Funny nobody told me. Definitely told him to keep me informed. A very interesting case. Very interesting case. Well, here's the two of you. Happy to be going now. Nice to see you, Anders.
Yes, yes.
No twinge at all, huh? Good. Well, goodbye.
Goodbye. Great guy, Doctor. And a modest fellow, too.
He died 2 weeks ago.
Huh? Say, what do you say we go out and ride the cable cars? There's a wonderful view of the bay.
He died? No, he didn't. He didn't die at all.
Of course he did.
It's Bob. He was talking about Bob.
Oh, don't be silly, Bob. Bob, he's fine. He's just got a little leg wound.
He knows, doesn't he? You and Hanson, you're standing by, aren't you? That's why you never leave him alone. That's why you're always so gay. So he won't have time to think about it.
Can I get you a table, sir?
Oh, no, thanks. We're just looking for some friends. Oh, you better snap out of it. Here he comes. Well, here you are. What you been up to? Can I trust you alone?
Hiya, Hodger.
Say, how about a drink here?
Where? Yes, sir. What'll it be?
A couple of refills on what they're having, and a bourbon and soda for me.
Yes, sir.
Oh, yes, and a beer for my grandchild.
Hey, we couldn't find no general out at the Presidio. Someone got things all mixed up.
Shakespeare, may I have another cigarette, please?
Guess it's a funny thing. I can't understand that. All the way out there in a taxi, nobody ever heard of a General Nixon. Nixon. That's the army for you. Nixon was what you... How do you like this guy? Oh, trying to move in on my gal, huh? Well, I'll fix that. Hacha, you and I are going dancing tonight without...
Without what?
Without these two primary cadets.
Oh, no, you...
Oh, I think I'm still the superior officer around here, and of course the most fascinating fellow. However, just to make it fair, we'll leave up the young lady. What do you say? Hacha, what do you say?
Well, I...
You see? All settled. Very simple. Go out and find yourselves a couple of blondes now.
Bob, doesn't it bother your leg to dance?
Bother my what? Oh, you're thinking of old peg leg here. Nothing wrong with my leg.
Cherry, bourbon, and beer.
Oh, good. Pay the man.
Oh, I always got it.
Pay the man.
Oh.
Gosh, I'm proud of you. You look so wonderful tonight. Just like you looked that night in Chicago.
You mean when I stood you up?
Yeah. Aren't you ashamed, though?
That was a long time ago.
Oh, I don't know. Seattle, Des Moines, Chicago, only 3 days.
Was it really only 3 days ago? Hard to believe, isn't it? A week ago, I never knew you existed.
You can live a long time in 3 days. Sometimes when you're in a tight spot, you can live a year in 10 seconds.
You've done that, haven't you? It's not a bad way either. To crowd everything there is to live for in a day, a week, or a month.
Shall we dance?
Ask him to play our song.
Oh, yeah, play our song, would you?
Glad to, Major. You tell me what the name of the song is.
Oh, yes. What is it?
You came to me from out of nowhere.
I certainly never thought the time would come when I'd like fog. I don't know. I like everything tonight.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for a lovely evening.
Fun, wasn't it?
A good song ringing clear, it rings so clear.
What time do we get to San Bernardino?
Purdue.
Huh?
San Purdue is what the Californians call it. It's where the oranges come from. I'll be there in about 15 minutes. I'm getting excited.
What, about seeing an orange?
About seeing my sister. Today's wedding day, you know.
Well, personally, I've never believed the story. I don't think you have a sister.
Just in a few minutes. Uncle Jack and Francis are going to meet us at the airport. And after the bond rally, we're going to drive over to Mission Inn at Riverside for the wedding. They're going to be married at the Flyers Chapel. Uncle Jack says it's a very romantic place.
Oh, that's what I like, romantic places. Me too.
We're just showing all his friends around the inn. I'm so glad you came, Major. It's nice to have such guests at my niece's wedding.
Well, thank you.
This is really quite a place. A lot of interesting things here, especially to you aviators. Bill, here's something of particular interest to you. This propeller serves as a special register for all the flyers who are married here in the chapel. You'll put your signature there after the ceremony.
Well, I'd be glad to. Glad to get it over with, huh?
Oh, this is very interesting. That windsock blew over Howland Island when Amelia Earhart made her final flight.
She never saw it, huh?
No, she never did. You know that she was right here in this patio just before she started on that flight. Well, her wings are right over here on the flyer's wall. All the famous flyers come here at one time or another and leave their signatures here on these wings. You notice?
Yeah, Jimmy Doolittle.
And there's General Arnold.
And Billy Bishop, what do you know?
And Jacqueline Cochran.
Lincoln Ellsworth. And Kingsford Smith.
We call him B. Kelly, Jr.
And this is St. Francis of Assisi, the patron saint of flyers.
Deus meus et omnia, St. Francis of Assisi, lover of birds and birdmen.
Yes, he is. And I have some souvenirs for you, boys. These are the medals that are given to all flyers who visit.
Thank you.
I hope they'll bring you luck.
He giveth you your wings to fly and breathe a pure air on high and careth for you everywhere.
Who for yourself so little care.
Oh, what happened to your captain friend?
He's checking us in and probably looking up some vital statistics.
Yeah, he's probably making some phone calls for us.
Oh, Ivy, I'll show you to your room, dear. Francis, it's time to get dressed for the ceremony.
I guess that's right. Well, this is the last time I'll see you before we're married.
All right. Come along.
You're not nervous or anything, are you? Well, I think the occasion demands now that we have a small ceremony with you. How about that short snort?
Yeah, long short snort, and we're gonna buy it, too.
Come on.
I like your flyers, darling. They're so cheerful. Boy, it'll be a lovely wedding. Isn't it exciting to be married in the Flyers' Chapel?
I suppose so.
I think it'll bring us luck.
Certainly it will.
Ivy.
Yes?
Do you think it's right, our getting married?
Why?
Well, do you think when Bill sent away, having a wife, would that make it better for him or worse?
I don't know. Francis, if you knew he was going to die...
Oh, don't say it.
If you knew for sure, would you still marry him?
Of course I would.
Doesn't really matter, does it? 1 year or 20 years. Just a few weeks.
Why do you say that?
When you love each other very much, and it really doesn't matter.
Well, you certainly must be awfully happy anyway. Say, Major, do you mind if I ask you a very personal question?
Shoot.
Well, I haven't anybody else to ask. You see, I haven't told Francis yet, but I've received my orders. I'm to go any day now.
Oh, it's tough luck.
Oh, I don't mind. But I want to be sure now, at the last moment, that I'm doing the right thing.
Which thing is that?
Getting married. You see, anything's liable to happen to me. You know, it's not that I'm afraid, because I can think of it and I don't mind. What I can't think of is... Is leaving somebody at home who'll get hurt and stay hurt and never stop. Yes, you understand. For you, it'll be quick, like a debt paid and done with. But somebody'll go on paying and paying and never quite reach the paid in full. Yes, I... suppose that's what it is. You've been overseas and come out safely. That's why I thought you could tell me. Oh, who can tell that? It's whatever each man decides for himself. And I guess whatever he decides is the right answer. One other one?
Oh, Oh, sure. You?
Of course.
Oh, that's right. Say, that's awful pretty.
Aren't they, though? My wedding ring and navy ring.
Say, these navy anchors come in small sizes, don't they?
I hope it'll hold. He's going away so very soon.
Sure it will.
Here we are. Come on, come on. Buttons up. We can't have an empty glass in the
house. Thank you.
Who wants a drink?
We do.
Good. Coming up. Take care of my niece now, won't you? You wouldn't drink too much, would you?
Why not? It's my sister's wedding.
To us? To the four of us. Well, I can't argue with that.
Bottoms up.
Roger.
Now I think it's my dance, isn't it?
It isn't.
Wait a minute. You're getting to be too popular.
Do you really mind?
No, I guess not a girl like you. Well, I suppose you must have a man somewhere in the service or back east, maybe?
A whole lot of them.
But not one that is not an important one anywhere.
No.
It's too bad.
Why?
I guess it'd be better if you had.
Well, there's one man I like.
There is? Who is he? What's he like? What's his name?
Shakespeare. I like him very much, don't you?
Oh, yeah. Shakespeare's a... Say, Shakespeare, that reminds me. You were looking very serious when we came back from the Presidio yesterday. What were you talking about, you and Shakespeare?
I don't remember.
What did he tell you?
Oh, nothing. Just his usual nonsense.
Did he, tell you anything about me?
No. Why?
He should have warned you.
About what?
Kind of man I am.
What kind?
Oh, kind that loves him and leaves him.
Are you?
Mm-hmm. Nice girl should never take me seriously. Never give me a second thought. No future in it for him. Can't be.
Suppose she doesn't care about that.
Well, she should know it anyway.
And if you cared for her?
That's when I'd want her to know what I was like.
Would you tell her that?
I am telling her.
Well, we agreed it'd just be fun up in the air.
That's what I want you to remember.
Remember. Did you ever see the stars so bright?
You ought to see them from 20,000 feet. They look like a bunch of electric lights.
I like the stars.
Yeah, they're the flyers, friend.
Are they?
Sure, we navigate by it. There's my best friend over there, Polaris.
Polaris?
Yeah, the North Star. Come here. See the Big Dipper up there? No. Over here. Now, follow the outside of the cup right on up. And see that pale fellow there? That's Polaris. Gee, about a year ago, I had my instrument shot away by flak. No Polaris shining up there brought me back to England. I had to go due west, and Polaris is straight north. So I put him to my right shoulder, and he brought me safely home. Like this. You want to come home? Look over your right shoulder to Polaris.
Well, look at that. And where have you been so early in the morning?
Out.
We've been looking all over for you. Aren't you going to have any breakfast?
Chummy, isn't it?
Looks like something's bothering him.
Hubba, hubba.
Thank you.
Shakespeare and Anderson were looking for you.
Were they?
I have to leave for Wichita in a few hours.
Well, yes, I, got something for you.
Willa Murray.
Take it. You got it coming to you. Wait a minute. Take it. Promise me something. Something important. You've got to keep this promise, you understand? You've got to keep it.
I can try very hard.
No matter what happens, and no matter when, don't ever grieve me, baby. Don't ever grieve me.
Sorry.
No, not Hotchkiss. Collins, honey, Collins.
Well, congratulations, you two. The meaning of this solemn occasion...
No, save those speeches for the bar round.
All right, I'll make it short. You see, we used to be a triangle, and now we've become a square.
Yeah, but what good's a square on a honeymoon?
No time for honeymoon.
Well, the happy trip will soon be over.
We're landing at Mitchell Field, aren't we?
Yes, that's where we're going to end up. What a waste of talent. A whole city from which to choose a better parking lot.
I settled for the Empire State Building.
All right, you can have it if I can have the Chrysler Building and the Rockefeller Center.
Which one do you want?
The smallest one I can find.
The smallest?
We'll have somewhere on Long Island with a lawn and garden.
The fireplace in the living room?
And a breakfast nook with glass walls.
And a back porch?
With a vine all over it and a white kitchen.
And a four-burner range and an electric icebox? Glad you got the house. You know, it was lucky for you that Colonel Barnes was transferred to California.
We picked the house long distance.
Long distance?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, from the air, you see.
Yeah, from the... Yes, indeed. young couples must have their little joke. Well, we're only young once. Got to be happy now, so we'll have something to remember on our golden wedding anniversary.
We'll be very happy here.
I'm sure of it. Well, good night, folks. Here are the keys.
Oh, thank you.
And the best of luck.
And same to you.
Good night, and thank you so much. It's wonderful. There's no other house like it in the whole world.
What's wonderful about it? All these houses look alike to me.
This one is ours.
Yes.
Funny to think that all those other people in all those other houses have gone through the same thing this first evening.
Oh, they must have.
It seems like something that's never happened before. A new thing. A world discovery. Only, you can never tell the world about it.
Yes. We'll go in and everything will be shut out. The city and the streets and the sky. Space and time. Sure. We'll never know inside whether it was an hour or a week or... 10 years.
Won't matter.
thing. You think it'd be a good idea if I nail my good luck coin up over the door?
Oh, no. No, you must always keep it with you.
I'll always keep it with me. That's wonderful.
Yes, it's wonderful.
I'm talking about the coffee, Monkey.
The coffee, too.
Break bread on that? Woman, give me that coat. You're bad for my morale.
Why?
Well, I hate to have to go, but they couldn't run Mitchell Field without me. I'm indispensable, you know. Say, what are you going to do today?
Something very important.
Oh? What's that?
I'm going to buy a new hat. Well, you can laugh if you like. But when you see it, maybe you'll want to take me out someplace.
All you have to do is speak up. You want to go out?
No.
That's funny. I don't either.
Well, we hadn't been any place for months, so I thought I'd make the effort, in case you wanted to have a good time.
Say, wait a minute. Look, I am having a good time. I want you to know that. Why, this is exactly what every man overseas dreams about. Some of them make it, and, well, some of them don't. I'm a lucky guy, luckier than most. I want you to remember that. You will, won't you?
Roger.
Come on. I've got to go and run the Air Force. Oh, yes, incidentally, no matter what anybody says, buy that hat. I love you. Goodbye.
Goodbye, dear.
For it's always fair.
Yep. Thanks, Sergeant.
Something from your draft board.
Yes. I've got something to attend to. Put my chute in the bin, will you?
Sure.
Is this the little girl you were out with last night?
Kind of sharp, eh? She's a cute little number. Got red hair, too.
Well, she looks like the little English girl. You know, the barmaid at the pub in college.
Well, you mean the one that fell for Doug Nichols?
Yeah, they're believing he was a millionaire.
Yeah, good old Doug. He could make them believe anything.
You know, I was with him when he got it. We were over the channel coming back from Dieppe when the Jerry swarmed all over us. Boy, he went down like a rock. I kept watching for the parachute, but never showed up.
Poor guy.
Oh, I don't know. At least he went like that. I only feel bad when they linger like Jackie Sutherland.
Yeah. 3 months in the hospital, and then he went anyway.
Hey, wait a minute. You know, we're getting morbid. That's what comes of flying a desk.
You want to change the subject, I'll give you something to talk about.
What?
Got my orders today.
Yeah? Where are you going?
Back overseas.
You're kidding.
No fooling. Leaving tomorrow.
Let me see.
See what?
The orders, old boy, the orders.
What's the matter? Don't you believe me? What have I got to do, carry my orders around in my pocket to show you guys? You heard what I said, didn't you? I'm going back overseas. You want to make anything out of it?
No, we don't want to make anything out of it. We're going to miss him, aren't we, Shakespeare?
Yeah. Don't know what we're going to do without him. Such a sweet nature. Goodbye, old boy. Hey, hey, hey. Remember us? No goodbyes. Always the best, you know that. Say, look in on Ivy now and then, will you? Both of you.
Oh, sure.
She know you're leaving?
No, not yet. I'll tell her when I get home.
Give her my love.
I'll do that. Keep that left hook in there.
Yeah. Knock over a couple for me, will you?
I'll do that little thing.
Well? No goodbyes.
No goodbyes. So long, fella. Be seeing you around.
Good luck, old boy. Hi, good looking.
Well, hello, you're home early. I haven't even taken my bath yet.
Good. Can I wash your back?
Maybe.
What are we waiting for?
Again. That's better.
Say, I would.
My new hat.
Fruit and vegetables, no spinach, huh?
Don't need any, I'm full of vitamins. Unbutton me, please.
Well, you're sure full of something.
I've got to stop eating those desserts. Wait till I let my breath out.
Say, I've got some news for you.
Good or bad?
Oh, good. Got my orders today.
Orders?
Yep. Going back overseas. Say, how do you expect me to get this dress unbuttoned? Will you stop breathing?
Combat?
No, I wish it was. It's just advanced combat instruction.
When are you leaving?
Tomorrow.
When did you say?
Tomorrow morning. There you are. It's all unbuttoned now. You can turn around. Honey.
I'm going to miss you, Bob. I'm going to miss you.
I'm going to miss you, too.
Now come wash my back. English girl's pretty.
Yes. They're beautiful girls.
You know, I expect you to go out sometime. I don't want you to be a hermit.
Well, that goes for me, too.
Only, don't take out the prettiest girls. Just something kind of halfway, you know.
I told Shakespeare and Handsome to look in on you now and then.
Did you?
So you won't get lonesome.
Will you write me often? Mm-hmm. I'll write you every day.
Well, that'll be swell.
You don't have to write me every day. Just whenever you find time for it.
You only have a few minutes more. It isn't very long.
Nope. Well, I...
Which way would a plane fly to get to London?
Northeast.
Which way is that?
Somewhere in that direction.
Hello. May I have the hospital, please? Hello. Is Dr. Stubbs there? Could you tell me where I can reach him? Where? Oh, the Walter Reed General Hospital, Washington, D.C. Are you sure?
Special delivery for Mrs. Robert Collins.
Is that for me?
Sign here, please.
Thank you.
Good night.
Good night. Letter from Bob.
Don't mind us. Go right ahead and read it.
I'll read it to you. Dearest, landed safely after pleasure trip. I have a couple of days leave in London before I report for duty. I'm staying at the Hastings Hotel where the manager is an old friend of mine.
Well?
The rest is rather private.
Hastings Hotel, huh? Say, isn't that where the redhead lives?
What redhead?
You know, the one with the shape.
Oh, yeah, that one.
Still private? Well, I'll tell you what to do. You go into the sitting room and have yourself a good read.
Yeah, and answer it, too.
We'll take care of everything and do the dishes.
Thank you.
Ah, what a wonderful dinner.
Yeah, it sure was.
What are you waiting for? Get a move on.
Move what?
The dishes. Now take off your coat and start checking that sink, junior officer.
Oh, I always got to do all the work.
Look, here's a letter from Major Collins and a letter from Mrs. Collins, both from the United States and both addressed to each other at this hotel.
Yes.
I still don't quite understand it, sir.
Major Collins is in the hospital in the United States, and he doesn't want his wife to know it.
Oh, well, shall I readdress the letters, Sadie, before?
If you please.
Hi, beautiful.
You ready for the game?
As soon as I get my coat.
Here, I brought you a little present.
Oh, how nice, but you should have done it. Oh, they're lovely. Thank you so much.
Nothing at all, nothing at all. Seeing that you're going out with two such charming gentlemen, we wanted you to look your best.
What do you mean? She always looks her best.
You heard from Bob lately?
Just received this. Oh, excuse me.
Mrs. Robert Collins, sign here, please. Telegram.
Bet Bob's having a time over there.
Yeah. I just talked to a fellow who flew back yesterday. Said he saw Bob in the Piccadilly Circus on Saturday with a blonde on one arm and a brunette on the other.
What a guy.
I regret to inform you that your husband, Major Robert Collins, died at Walter Reed General Hospital. My deepest sympathy extended to you and members.
Much as it has pleased Almighty God of His great mercy to take into Himself the soul of our dear comrade, grant to us. From the contagion of the world's slow stain, we are secure.
Kicked out of our place last night.
Yeah, we were making too much racket.
Well, maybe we might stay here for a few days.
It's only till we can get another place.
All right.
Of course.
Say, can we have a drink?
Help yourself. You know where it is.
Sure. But a pour one for you.
I think it'll do you good.
Yeah, it'll do you good. Here it is.
Take it.
Well?
Well.
I want you to know that. This is exactly what every guy overseas dreams about. Some of them make it, and, well, some of them don't. I'm a lucky guy. lucky at the most. I want you to remember that. You will, won't you?
To the four of us.